You join me today at a fantastic fishery called Woodlands View near Kidderminster. It's a fishery that I've been lots and lots of times. It's solid with carp, it's solid with F1s, and actually it's solid with silverfish. But I'm going to aim today to catch the carp. As you can probably tell from the leaves, it's going into October time now. The temperatures are dropping. I've not got a lot of bait with me. Carp fishing this time of year can be really, really simple. And I'm going to turn around now, give you loads and loads of tips on how to keep catching carp during the winter months. Right, bait for today, nice, simple. You know, when you're carp fishing this time of year, keep it simple and it will definitely put more fish in your net. Now, one of the main baits for going into this time of year, whether it's like October or even when it's really freezing cold, it's got to be corn. Corn is a great bait, you know, whether you're fishing a pole or whether you're fishing a waggler even. I catch a lot of fish during the winter on a waggler as well with corn. Always bring some corn with you. You don't need loads, a couple of tins is normally enough. But obviously I've got my little selection of Woodlands View fishery pellets here. 2 mils. If things aren't really happening, you know, I might not put these in at the start, but as the session goes on, if I think the fish aren't feeding, I'm not getting many indications, we can introduce some 2 mils. And also in the margins, this time of year, if you're not allowed to use ground baiting on some of the venues you go to, you will definitely have to take some 2 mil pellets. And I've just got another selection. I've got some 4 mils. Again, fantastic bait, you know, to keep the fish in your peg. You know, if you're trying to target the bigger fish, normally you can introduce the bigger pellets, you know, and just fish corn on the hook. So I've also got some fishery 6 mils as well. I can put these on the hook with a band, or I can actually feed them. I'm not sure what's going to happen yet, but obviously we'll talk about that as we go along with the filming. But one of the most important baits as well is expanders. You know, wherever you go, wherever you're fishing for all sorts of different fish, take a small selection of expanders with you. Some days they will pick these pellets out better than any other bait. And I've just brought a little selection of pro expanders. I've got some 4 6s and I've got a few 8s, because you never know, and you're in the late in the session, if you're down the edge trying to catch some right big fish over them little micros, a big hook bait like a big expander can be absolutely deadly. Really, really simple to do. I've talked through it before, but get yourself a little container like that, a little sealed container. I'd actually done these at about 6 o'clock last night before, you know, on the evening. I use cold water, put the pellets in first, put your selection of whatever size pellets you're going to take to your peg the next day, and just fill the container right up with freezing cold water. If you use cold water, they're even better. And you can just get these out, there's no pumping involved, and they're absolutely perfect for going on the hook. So if you bring yourself a nice little selection of expanders like I have today, just for the hook, like I said, they can be absolutely deadly. So there you go, nice and simple bait selection. And if you keep it nice and simple like I have, you will definitely catch more carp. Right, rig choice I've made up for today, nice and simple again. This is the rig I've actually made up for out long. But I'm starting at 14.5 meters. I'm away from the bank. We've had a real cold morning. And I think at the start of the day, I think the fish are going to be long and hopefully will come in later on. But the rig I've set up for long, first off, I've got a little medium cab pot on there with a little lid on it. So I can put pellets and corn in there. No problem at all. I've opted for an 11 hollow, which I think is absolutely perfect. You know, if I'm catching the odd F1 and the odd bream, I'm going to get them out. No problem at all. 017 reflow power line down to one of the new carp pellet floats, and as you can see, it's got a 2 mil hollow bristle, so that's going to stand out fantastically fishing it long distance, and it's going to hold the bait up really nice. So going down to the shot in, nice and simple, I've just got a little bulk of 9s. Obviously you can use stots as well, but I've opted for a few 9s shot, and I've literally got 2 number 9 droppers. So the bulk from the hook to the bulk is probably about 18 inches. And I've got 2 number 9 droppers in between the bulk and the top of the loop of the hook length. So down to the hook length, nice and simple. I've just got a pre-tied GPM on 013 reflow power. So nice and simple. There's no messing around. Just one thing, always, which we'll talk about as I'm going through the session, always mark the depth with a bit of Tippex. You know, that's really, really important. If you lose a carp, you know, the line stretch can actually move your float. So always mark it with a little bit of Tippex. Now the other rigs, I've set up a rig for short, exactly the same setup as my long line. So the only thing I haven't got is a little lid on there, because when I'm fishing short, if I want to be sort of putting lots of corn in there, I can literally put loads of corn in, give that a little bit of a push down with my thumb, go out and pang it out. I mean, this is going to be later in the session, but it's exactly the same rig, 11 hollow, 017 mainline, exactly the same float, because it's probably about 8 inches shallower than my long line. So a 4x14 carp pellet, and exactly, so I've actually got stots on here. So obviously it depends on what you want to use. I've just done a variation for you, so you can use shot or stots. Stots are absolutely fantastic if you're using thick lines. They don't come off and they do not damage your line whatsoever. Now on this line, because I'm fishing for short, I've got a good chance of catching some really big carp. I've stepped this hook length up to 015 reflow power to a 14 GPM. Once again, pre-tied, 6 inches on the rig and you're away. The only other rig I've set up is my edge rig. Now, once again, obviously, I'm not sure what's gonna happen. The water temperature's dropped off a lot in the last few weeks, so they might come in right at the end of the session. But we're on back dings today. There is some absolute huge carp in here. And if we do catch Danny Edge later, make sure you're set up for it. So I've just gone up a little bit on elastic. I've got a 12 Dura hollow on there. I've got 019 reflow power mainline, and I've got a little 4x10 island float, nice thick bristle, nice and strong so you can see it. You know, if you want to put double corn on, it's going to hold the bait no problem at all. And I'm probably fishing in about 18 inches of water, not right against the bank. I've just dropped down the shelf a little bit because of the water temperature. And I've set up on there, I've got an 017 hook length of reflow power, but I've got a size 14 XSH hook. So I've gone up in line diameters and I've also gone up in hook strength. So perfect setup for fishing down the edge. And there you go, that's the three rigs that I've got up set up for today. Okay, I'm ready to go now. The only thing I've done since we last spoke was I've actually soaked my 2mm fishery pellets. So I've kept them, I've got them in a little pellet wetter, put them in the water for probably like 20 seconds and brought them out. That's gonna start the breakdown process of the pellets, which I think is gonna be really important, especially when I'm fishing down the edge for the carp. Now, like anywhere you go on a commercial like Woodlands View, you know, where do you start? I think, because the temperature's still pretty good, I would have thought the water temperature is probably around sort of 11, 12 degrees. I'm just going to start on my short line. You never know, you might go in there and you might just catch a real big carp first chuck, but I'm going to start by feeding the long line. So I've got my big pot, I'm not going to put a lot of bait in, I'm just going to feed some 4mm. I've probably got like 44mm there of the fishery pellets, and I'm going to put about 20 grains of corn in. So a little bit of both, keep it nice and simple. Like I said, I'm fishing long, you know, you can fish 13 meters. I've decided to fish 14 and a half, but I am gonna go in on that short line. I'm not gonna feed that short line, I'm gonna feed that the little pot when I go in there. So, got my roller set up behind me. Keep it nice and, you know, nice and steady. Get out to where you're gonna be fishing. I got myself lined up with a tree on the opposite bank. And I'm just gonna literally shake that out like that. So it's not a lot of bait. And I get back, so actually on my short line, I'm fishing a top kit plus 3, because on this peg, it goes out to like a top kit plus 2, which is where I like fishing, but you're not going down the shelf. It actually goes out, it's like a bit of a plateau, and then it drops off on a top kit plus 3. And that's where I've decided to fish, partly because the water temperature, like I said, is getting colder. And I've got everything set up here. I've got my little tulip, I've got my pole in the sock. So, you know, look at my little setup there. It's absolutely perfect. You're not gonna break anything. So get me pot out of the way. I'm gonna pick my short line up. Another little pointer as well. Have a nice distance of line between your elastic and your float. It's about 12 inches. If you start off about 12 inches, it's nice and easy to fish to that sort of length of line. Now I'm gonna start on a 6mm expander. Another little tip with them expanders. I've kept that, I've put them in a tub, but keep them in the cold water. Don't let them dry out. If you keep them in water like that, they stay perfect all day. And I'm gonna just wet my elastic a little bit. I'm just gonna put a few 4mm, probably about 15 4mm in there. No corn at the moment. I'm just gonna go in and see if I can get a quick bite. I mean, sometimes some of the matches I fish, you can catch, you know, 3 or 4 carp if you're lucky. Sometimes you don't get a bite, but it's worth just going in and having a quick look. I'm just gonna shake them 4mm out, just spread them out a little bit. And them expanders, for some reason, they just come in, mop them up. You get a real aggressive bite as well. A little indication then, actually. I think that was a fish that was actually up in the water. And you sometimes get that when you start on these commercials, you know, they'll come into the bait straight away. But definitely want a bite on the bottom. That was a liner. So I'm not gonna feed again. Another 6mm expander. So just be nice and patient. Got me pole above me float, because it's a nice day today, it's nice and still. Even though it's quite cold, you can hold the pole over top your float, so when I do get a bite, you know, I don't have me pole like that, because I've got like 12 inches plus between me float and the elastic, so I try and hold the pole above me float, but you can see the little bit of line. I'm not doing this, I'm not moving me float around. I've got that little bit of slack line in the water, so I'm not affecting the presentation of the float. There's a little tiny, there we go, that was a tiny little bite then. Little skimmer. So that's a skimmer on a 6mm expander. But I don't mind catching them on a cold day like today. So I've got my two keep nets in the water, one for silvers, one for carp. Nice little 8-ounce skimmer. And my float was sat a little bit low then, so I'm gonna take one of my number 11 starts off. It's as easy as that. Make sure you get all the slime off your hook length. I'm gonna try another 6mm expander again. I'll just hook that down through the middle, so the hook is right in. Just gonna put a few more falls in this time. And what you can do as well, if you're not using like I am with a lid on, drop your pot in the water like that before you ship out, and that helps the pellets stay in the pot, so you're not gonna lose all the pellets on the way out. But it's worth just having a little look short. You know, some matches I fish, I've had a fantastic start short. Now that float should be sat a little bit higher now, which it is. So that number 11 I've taken off. I mean, that's perfect now for fishing like for carp. Little bit of float showing. There we go, absolutely fantastic bite then. Doesn't feel like a carpo. I think that might be an F1. I mean, that 11 holo is absolutely bang on, even for those F1s. Especially, you know, we're not in the sort of freezing cold weather. Nice big F1. So that's worth doing, just going on that short line. Just took that number 11 stot off. I think that float was sat absolutely bang on then. Take your time. I'm not gonna probably use the puller bung on this. There's only a little fish. Got everything to hand. Got my landing net ready. And then one tip as well, when I net the fish, as long as there's small fish like that, try and keep the top kit in your right hand if you're right-handed like me, and then bring your landing net back with your left hand. And then, you know, it's an art to do that, but when you get into it, you're so much more efficient. And then I can grab the fish, because it's only a smallish fish, I can grab that by one hand like that. I can bring that fish over to my right hand, get the hook out, put the fish back in the landing net into the keep net. So you're not going to damage the fish either. And I'll keep me landing net like that. I've got my top kit already. I've not put the top kit down in the mud, so I know there's not going to be any mud on the inside of the top kit, which is going to wreck your pole. And I'm back fishing again. So another 6mm expander. Now I'm just going to just sort of ease my way into this. I'm going to put like 10 4mm in. Like I said, you can just dunk that in the water first before you ship out. That's going to help keep the pellets in if you've not got a lid on. Well, I'm going to give it this chuck. I've had that skimmer, had that F1, definitely had a couple of little silverfish bites, but it was worth just going in. On a, you know, on some days you might go in there, you might even catch a 10-pound carp, you might catch a couple of carp, and it can get, you know, it can get you a fantastic start while you're just waiting for that long line to hopefully get some fish in it. But it is that time of year, you know, when the water starts cooling off, a couple of frosts. You know, oh, that was a tiny little bite then. I'm gonna have one more chuck on that. There's definitely a few skimmers around, which is good anyway. Just gonna feed a few more 4mm pellets. Not many. Make sure you get to the end of the pole. And drop that. So it's another little, just a little grain of corn on the hook. I love this sort of fishing when you just don't know what you're going to hook next. It can be like a, you know, a 10-ounce skimmer, it can be an F1, it can be a carp. Definitely some silverfish there. So what I'm going to do, I'm just going to go out on my long line. I think if there had been a carp there, I think I'd have hooked it straight away. Then I get my long line, and I'm just going to go straight out on a piece of corn on that line. So 10 minutes short. Little piece of corn again. Not going to put anything in, just going to go out there on that little bit of bait that I put in. So if you can't fish 14 and a half, just do it at sort of 13 or 11. Don't overdo yourself. I just fancy with the conditions, with it being flat calm, getting out into the lake a little bit. Same principle, just try and hold your pole above your float with that sort of 6 inches of line in the water. It's easier to do today, obviously, because it's flat calm. And you might have to be scratching around for the first sort of, you know, you might have to scratch. Oh yes, there we go. Tiny little indication then. I didn't even virtually strike it that. I'm not sure what that is. So I've actually got to ship down twice or break down twice. So I get down to about 10 meters, got my stock there, I'll put my big sections in. And then the other sections I'll put in my tulip like that. I think that might be actually another F1. A little stocky, I think that. But that's welcome, you know, I don't mind that. Getting some bites. A little stocky F1, brand new looking at him. Get him back in. Oh, there you go. Tiny little bite again then. I've actually come back and put another little pot of corn in. But as I said, don't just sit there. We're not in the, you know, really, really cold weather yet. These fish, I'm sure, are going to still want a bit of bait. So I've come back, filled my little pot up, and within like literally 10 seconds after feeding, I've had that little indication. It is an F1, oh. Well, I'm not fussed, you know, when the water temperature drops, it's about getting bites, building your peg up. That's a nice F1. Get in there. Lovely Woodlands View F1. Little piece of corn. See that hook, 16 hook in his top lip. Beautiful fish, let's get him back. So that's nice, we've had two bites out there. I'm just gonna throw a couple of 4 mils on that short line. Not all the time, just put a little bit of bait in. I'm gonna fill that little medium cab pot up with corn. Got that little lid on there with the hole in it so it holds everything in while you're shipping out. Just get out to where you're fishing, tip the pole upside down, and just tap it around a bit. I'm not tipping it all in the same area, I'll just tip it out of the little line. Did you hook bait into that? Them floats sit absolutely bang on. I've actually taken the number 11 stot off of that as well. There you are. See that indication? Ridiculous. It's another F1, I think. So that's nice. Little tiny indication. Even with that thicker bristle, they can. Of that float, it's like a 2 mil bristle, it still showed up that little indication. Sometimes you think, oh, was that a line at the bottom? Just struck into that, and it's that, you know, it's perfectly hooked, 100% in the mouth. Another big F1. You can tell it's a bit colder, they're not fighting probably as hard as what they would when the water temperature's up. Another pound and a half F1. Look at the condition of them. Absolutely immaculate. Perfectly hooked top lip, just like literally just inside the top lip. So that's lovely. Starting to get a few bites now. It's a typical sort of cold water day. You know, you get an odd little indication to tell you that there's something there. And it's great fishing because they're not hanging themselves. You know, these are the days when all the little bits, you know, plumbing up right, getting your float dotted down. There you are. There's one just bow waved off as well then. I think that's another big F1. These are the days when you learn about fishing, when it's a bit colder, they're a bit harder to catch, a bit crafty. Nice F1 that, I think. F1s at the moment though, but I don't mind that. You know, like I said, just putting some fish in the net. Oh yeah, it's one of them ghosty F1s, I think. Putting up a good scrap, eh? Ooh. Lovely looking fish. A pound and a half again. Look at him. The ghosty F1. Again, just hook, top lip. Well, I've come back on my short line. I had a great, probably an hour and 45 minutes to 2 hours on that 40 and a half meter line. Most of the F1s, I have one good carp, about 8 pound. But I've just come back on that short line. I've had a carp and 3 big F1s, a couple of stockies. And I went in there, I've obviously been throwing a few of those 4 mils. Went in there, had a bite, and then I started throwing a bit more bait, but only 4 mils. And to be honest, I've had loads more bites by making a little bit of noise, a little bit of that feed dropping through a little bit more often. You know, you see then, I just fed, and you get a little indication. A lot of them are F1s, I think. But obviously, while I'm I've actually topped up the edge line twice with quarter of a pot of micros and a handful of corn, because it's obvious today that you've got to feed a bit of bait. It's not one of them days, it's not sort of cold enough where the fish have just turned off. You can feed bait, you can get fish in your peg. They're not easy to catch. Obviously the water temperature has gone down a lot in the last 3 weeks. I'm just flicking, oh, look at that. Absolutely brilliant. So that was just flicking that bit of corn, my hook bait, past the pole. So I'm gonna feed a bit of bait, like 20 pellets, 20 pellets. A bit like summer fishing really, but that noise has made a huge difference. A lovely F1 that. A lot of F1s feeding at the moment, but that can change rapidly. I've been on these venues before, and I've had two carp already. Nice little F1. Crafty fish, you know, if you can catch them, you can catch anything. Same rig, 4x14, just check your shot, make sure everything's nice. A little bit of corn, just hunting through for little bits of corn at the moment. And I'll keep varying that, you know, I'll put a little piece on, a big piece, and some will probably stand out. So that was just flicking it past like that. Obviously fed some pellets while I've played that fish. Don't forget about the 14 meter line. Before I come off of that, I've put a handful of 4 mils in and a handful of corn, because you never know. You know, you can come back to this, you only might get, you might not catch anything on certain days. Other days you might have a real good run and then you've got to leave it. Hopefully it carries on going. And that's the perfect match you want, whether you're summer fishing or winter fishing, is when you get on this line, whether you're fishing for carp or F1s, you can carry on catching because it's so much quicker and so much easier. And most importantly, you can throw bait there, whether it's corn, pellets, maggots. Little indication then. Just gonna flick my rig out. It's deadly. Flicking that rig out sometimes can just get you so many more bites and indications. Especially like the wise old fish, the big F1s, the big carp. There's no bubbles or anything like that. You know, I think because the water temperature has gone down a lot, that definitely, you know, definitely cuts out during the winter months. Oh yes, look at that for a bite. Nice big F1, I think that. So I'm gonna throw a few more pellets in. Not throwing corn, just pellets. As I went in there, I've been throwing a few 4 mils in, but corn on the hook definitely seems the best. It's a nice big F1 that, one of them big old boys that. Wise as you like. Look at him. Beautiful F1 that. Getting on for 2.5 pound, I would say that is. So a little bit of corn, flicking it past me pole tip. Oh, steady lad. Look at that. Big Woodlands View F1. Probably £3 that actually. Let's get him back. So what I'm gonna do, I'm just gonna pot some more bait in down the edge. I've not seen any signs down there. So I'm gonna get some fishery 2 mils, probably about a quarter of a pot, handful of corn, like that. Down the edge. Just slightly away from where I've plumbed up. So I've actually plumbed up there, but I'm potting the bait in there. And I think that reduces foul looking fish. Well, there you go. I've just hooked a carp now. So I've had them two big F1s, probably 2.5, £3 a piece. Went in, probably waited about a minute. And that's what I said. This line can go from, you know, an F1 skimmer line, and all of a sudden, if you can catch on it, it is absolutely brilliant. I mean, that 11 hollow is absolutely perfect. If it's a bit colder, and then obviously we're catching more silvers, I'd probably go down to like a 9 or a 10. But if you can get away with that 11, it gives you that added bonus. If you do hook some big carp like this, you get them under control a lot easier. I don't know where this one's going, down the edge. So I've just hooked that, thrown in like 10 4 mils. Corn seems to be the bait for the hook. Probably out there, you know, thinking, not sure really, thinking on that long line, maybe potting pellets in, fishing corn on the hook. I might have caught more carp, but you know, I was catching plenty of F1s, and you know, with it being cold, it's brilliant fishing. Look at that, nice big Woodlands View common. Oh, that's 8 pound. Didn't fight that hard really, considering. Try and hold this one up, because he's a beautiful carp. I love the commons. Brilliant condition. Probably not, he's probably 7 pound actually. Look at him. Brilliant. Well, like all anglers, they love to finish off down the edge. I've been priming that line up for probably 3 hours. I've just looked down there. I've not seen any tail patterns, but I've just seen a little bit of colour. So I'm going to go in there. So I've been feeding those micros in corn. Just get myself a nice big piece of corn. Hopefully I'll look one. I'm just going to put a little bit of corn in a little cab pot there. Just as a bit of a taster, really. We've had a great, it's been brilliant on that short line. You know, a few carp, some big F1s are. Just actually seen a little tail pattern then. So I'm hoping, I mean, these big boys in here won't be easy to catch. So I'm just inside of me bait, where I've been putting my bait in. Just gonna lift me corn out, drop it in. There's a lot of these big fish down the edge nowadays on these commercials. You make a little bit of a plop like that, and sometimes you can catch them as your hook bait's flying down through the water. There we go. Don't think that's a carpo, I think it's actually an F1. So just lift and drop then. I knew there was some up there. I was hoping it was going to be a great big carp. Little F1 down the edge. Caught an absolute boatload of these today. Go. Got a little F1. Definitely had some at bow wave off when I hooked that F1. And I think this is a ghosty, because as I hooked it, you could just see a bit of white under the water. So just priming that up. You know, it took a little bit of time. I've caught a few F1s down there. It feels like a decent carp. That 12 Dura Hollow, definitely better for these carp. You know, thicker lines, bigger hooks. Even the, you know, end of October, you can get away with it. Look at that. Nice carp, that. Not the biggest specimen in Woodlands View, but just shows priming that. Oh, he's a bit bigger than what I thought. I bet he's 6 pound. But I've never seen that. You know, even though he's a ghostie. Look at that, perfectly hooked. Even though he's a ghostie, I've never actually seen it before I hooked it, and I'm only fishing in literally 24 inches of water. Well, there you go. And what a fantastic looking fish to finish the little session off I've done for you today at Woodlands View. I'm sure there's some great tips you're going to pick up on how to keep catching fish like this during the winter months. Let's get him back, and I'll see you on the bank sometime.